Hi everybody, it's Corey with Martin Deerline here. Today we're going to talk about calibrating a 640 Flex Draper in hybrid mode. What hybrid mode is, it allows us to run two modes at once on our hydro handle. So button two allows us to run off ground rigid mode, and just by hitting number three we can get our header to run on ground in flex mode. One of the first things we need to do before we calibrate the header, we have to make sure our locks are removed on the bottom of the header here, all the way along, and that allows our header to go into flex mode and flex along properly. The second thing we need to do is to make sure we've unlocked our sensors, our on-ground sensors. So we need to come in, take the lock pin out, place it in the storage position here, and make sure our sensors are moving freely. Make sure when we push it up that they return to their open position again and that nothing is stuck. There is three of these sensors along the header here to do. So one in the middle, one on the right hand side, and the left hand side, the one I just did. Okay, today, like I say, we're going to calibrate this header in hybrid mode on this Gen 4 display in a 780 combine. In order to set it to hybrid mode, we need to get into the controller addresses first. And the way we do that is we hit our menu, then we come to our systems button, we hit our diagnostic center tab. Within that, we come to controller diagnostics, which gets us to our list of controllers on the combine. We need to come down to the LC1 controller, which is right here. Click into that, and then we get our list of addresses here. So I'm going to come down to address 130. In order to set hybrid mode. Okay, address 130 at the bottom. I'll click into it. Right now we have 1001 and 4 zeros. In order to get to hybrid mode, we need to change that. We click into it. We enter 1011 and then 4 zeros. We hit OK. And now it's changed to 10, 11, and 4 zeros. That's our hybrid mode. We come out, check our list. It's still at 10, 11 in hybrid mode. Now we're good to go to start a calibration process. We'll come out. The other thing I need to do now before we start our calibration is we need to come to the header button. And we're going to check our auto control. Make sure we've got our height resume engaged, our height sensing on, and our lateral tilt. Those are the most important ones there before we begin our calibration. Our feeder house float, we want to make sure is in the off. The dial speed, fore aft resume and real position, doesn't affect the calibration at all. So now we come out to our calibration, we X out of that page, come to our calibrations tab, and now we enter on the left side here, we want to get our header calibration list. The first calibration, and I'm not going to show you this one, I'm just going to explain it, is our feeder house lateral tilt range calibration, and this one has to be done with the header off. So if I was to go into the calibration, it would tell me to remove the header, but just for sake of time here, we're not going to show it. Just make sure you do that one at the beginning of the season with the header off. It just sets our lateral tilt from left to right, and away you go. So once that calibration is done, our header is put back on, and now we can do all of our rest of our calibrations. The next one down the list is our feeder house tilt calibration speed. We go into it, we hit the calibration button, and it's going to tell us what we need to do for parameters here. So as we see here, engine running at high idle, raise the feeder house fully, and manipulate the switch is when it tells us. So I'm going to hit high idle. My header is raised all the way up. And we can hit our start button. Now we just follow the list and it's going to tell us what we need to do here. So press and hold the header tilt left switch, so I'm going to hold it left. So you're going to end up tilting this header back and forth probably 6 or 7 times. Now it tells me to go to the right. So we have to sit here and hold the button. So right now it's tuning the weight of the header to the hydraulics on the combine. So it does take a little bit of time here, but just keep following the directions. As you see, it's slow right now and it will speed up at every cycle we do and get faster. Just takes a little bit of patience. Keep following the directions on the screen. There are our calibration is complete. Make sure we save our new changes. So we hit the save button. Now we're ready to head on to the next calibration, which will be feeder house raise speed calibration. So I'm just going to level my header before I begin. And now I hit my feeder house raise speed calibration. Again, hit the calibration button and follow the directions. Combine on level ground, engine running at high idle. Hit the start button and follow the directions. So here we want us to just tilt our header so it's at zero. There it is. Okay, now I can proceed. So lower feeder house resting on the ground. So I'm going to put it all the way down to the ground. Make sure it's all the way down so our sensors are right closed on the ground. Okay, hit your next button. And now we're going to press and hold the raise switch. Very similar to the tilt calibration, where it's going to be slow at the beginning and then it slowly speeds up as we cycle back and forth or up and down. Okay, calibration is complete on the raise speed. We want to hit the save button. And now we can proceed to the next one. Okay, the next calibration we're going to do is the feeder house tilt fore and aft range calibration. So basically our faceplate, we're going to tilt the range all the way fore and aft. Again, hit the button and just follow the calibration after we've hit the, follow the on-screen instructions here. So I'm going to hit the start. Okay, so fully tilt the feeder house aft. Ensure that the feeder house fore aft cylinders are fully extended. So we want to make sure we bring our feeder house tilt all the way back to get those cylinders fully extended. So I bring this all the way back. Okay, I hit next. And now it's going to tell me to ensure that the feeder house cylinders are fully retracted. So when I tilt the header forward, that will retract my cylinders. So I hit forward and now tilt my header all the way forward. Okay, there I'm all the way forward, cylinders are retracted, I hit next. Okay, raise or lower the combine to 40 inches off the ground. Normally you go out with a tape measure, but I've got a preset height here already, so I'm going to say that I'm at 40 inches already. Like I say, you would measure from the ground up to the physical point they're telling you on the pivot bolt on the side of the feeder house. I'm there already, I'm going to hit next. Tilt the feeder house, so with the combine on level ground, tilt the feeder house aft frame until the front face is vertical. Basically the way we do that is we're going to use our tilt button again, and we're going to look down at the feeder house now, and we're going to look at the slots on the feeder house. And I'm going to bring my feeder house tilted in until we get to that halfway point. Usually rule of thumb is right in that position there, your faceplate will be vertical to the ground. Okay, so that one I can come back to my screen now. And I can save that setting. Okay, I hit next. Now my calibration is complete. We've calibrated the tilt range fore and aft and middle position on our fore aft on the feeder house tilt. Save. Out of there again, now we come down to our header calibration. So again, in this calibration here, this is where we're going to be doing our hybrid mode, kind of our off-ground and on-ground mode, all in the same calibration. Hit the calibrate button. And follow the instructions again, hit start. So we need to level our header, which it already is level, but you just need to activate the button to let you continue to the next step. So now, decrease our cutter bar pressure. So two ways of doing it, I can rotate my dial here or I can just go on screen. So we need to get it under 1000 PSI, so I'm just going to hold the button and we're going to drop our pressure. Now it's dropping our HydroFlex pressure. Our knife is now relaxing, going into the on-ground mode. We're going to get it under 1000, and then it lets us to proceed to the next step. Now we need to lower the feeder house right to the bottom, right to the ground. Get it sitting right on the ground, all the way down. Header's all the way down now. Now we come back to the screen, and I hit next. And now it's telling me to raise my header. Okay, AHC rigid mode and flex mode has been calibrated. I hit next. Calibration confirm, I save it. Now we do the AHC performance tuning calibration, so we hit the next button. And we're just gonna hit the lower button on the header and just keep holding it. You're gonna see your header bounce up and down. It's basically gonna running on the off-ground sensors now, and it's gonna calibrate the speed of the hydraulics. Header's doing a little bit of a bounce there, calibrating itself. Okay, so now they want us to increase the pressure. So I'm going to increase my pressure till it lets me proceed to the next step. So basically what we're doing is we're making our cutter bar rigid now. Before we just calibrated the flex mode, now we're going to do the off-ground rigid mode. So we keep building our pressure here. Our knife is going to come up and come in the rigid state now when I get up to my 2800 RPM, or PSI I should say. Okay, now I'm going to press and hold the lower switch. And now it's just fine-tuning our off-ground sensors. Calibration is complete. Save. Last calibration we're going to do is our real position calibration at the bottom. Again, hit the calibration button and follow the on-screen instructions. High idle, hit start. Follow the instructions. Press and hold the reel extend switch. So this is going to extend my reels all the way out. And keep holding it until it proceeds to the next step. I'm going to keep holding it, my extend switch. Now to the lower, it wants me to lower the reels. So I'm holding my lower rate or reels lower position. Keep holding. And now I need to raise them. Keep holding. Now I need to retract for the last step. Now I'm retracting my reels. Calibration complete, and I save. So that completes our calibration list for our header. Again, a reminder, make sure that we're doing our header calibration at the beginning of the season when we start, when we first put our header on. And then mid-season, again, if we change headers, we put a different header on, make sure we run through the calibration process again.